Hi everyone, Mike here. And today I'm going to talk to you about how I remote control my task manager. And by remote control, I don't mean put things into my task manager. I mean allowing the real world to interact with and mark tasks as complete in my task manager. So if that sounds interesting to you, stick around for a second. If you've seen my previous videos and you hear me say task manager and you're wondering why I'm not saying OmniFocus, it's because I've recently switched over from OmniFocus to Things. And if you're interested in the how and whys of that decision, I have a link down in the description that will take you to a blog post on my site where I wrote up the thought process behind the transition over to Things. Nothing wrong with OmniFocus. I'm just really liking Things for my current setup right now. So read the blog post to learn more. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to remote control both OmniFocus and Things. And I'm going to go ahead and give you the answer right up front. It's an oldie, but a goodie, AppleScript. And when you hear AppleScript, you might be looking down to see when this video was published. And I promise you, I recorded this and am publishing this in the fall of 2022. And even with all the automation options out there right now, this AppleScript is running multiple times a day and dozens of times every month. And with over a year of those numbers, it's been rock solid and never failed. So let me show you the AppleScript that's been doing all this work. And we'll start with the OmniFocus one. It's just six super short lines of AppleScript. And the key is this right here, the task ID, which if you don't know how to access, I'll show you later in the video. So since the task ID is written into the AppleScript, you're going to need a separate copy for every task that you're trying to complete remotely. So let's switch over to the Things version. It's a little bit more verbose, but only by a line or two. And the nice thing about this is that it's only going to work on a task that's available today. And in my specific use case, this is actually a better version than the OmniFocus one. So if you saw those examples and you already have ideas flowing about how you want to apply them, by all means, there's a link in the description that will take you to a blog post on my site, which will have the code there for you to be able to copy and paste and to run wild with. But if you're intrigued but aren't quite sure why I'm doing this or how I use it in my day-to-day experience, stick around because I'll show you three different examples about how this works in my day-to-day experience. And I'll also show you how I write these AppleScripts because, as you might imagine, there's an automation behind it. So since you're interested, I keep everything in my task manager. I know some people find better success by having their habits in a habit tracking app and maybe their like chores and regular reminders in something like reminders, and keep their task manager just for big projects or really high important tasks. And I've tried using a system kind of like that before, but I always forget about the other two. I always stop tracking the habits or leave the reminders app building up, and I just work better when everything's in one place. That's why I keep everything in Things, but it can get really cluttered with all of those little tasks. So there's a couple different things that I do to organize that and make that be a little bit more effective for me. But the big one is this video. All of my habits and chores and things like that, I've automated the completion of as many of them as possible. And so I'll give you three examples of those here now, but just wanted to give you a little bit of context about why I do this. And it's mainly just because I have to have everything in one spot. So the first one I'll show you is my meditation habit that I'm trying to build. I've had this in a habit tracker before, but just haven't built it up. So it's in my task manager now, and I'm doing a little bit better with it. So this is what I showed you in the example AppleScript from earlier. And so if I run this AppleScript, it will mark the task meditate complete in Things. But if I have to remember to run a script to mark something complete, that's not super helpful. So the challenge is, how do I automatically trigger this script to run? So the app I use for meditating is called Calm, and I really like it a lot. And one of the things that works really well for me with the app is that when I'm done my morning meditation, I'll get an email asking me to reflect on today's daily calm. And that's the name of the subject of the email. So I'm one of those weirdos who actually likes and uses the Apple Mail app. And one of the things that the Apple Mail app can do is run an AppleScript as part of a email rule. So what I set up in Apple Mail was a rule. When I receive an email with the subject line, reflect on today's daily calm, run this AppleScript, and then delete the message. Sorry, calm. Thank you for sending the email because it's really helpful, but I never read it. So since this email gets sent by Calm pretty much immediately after finishing the meditation, the task in Things is complete before I've even exited the Calm app. It's pretty much instantaneously marked complete. And that's a great first example. Imagine anything that is in your task manager that is something that you receive an email about when it's done. This is a really powerful way for you to have a reminder in your to-do list, but have it marked complete automatically when you finish the task elsewhere. It's by running this Apple Mail rule to run an AppleScript. But the initial inspiration for this AppleScript was actually being able to mark tasks complete from shortcuts. So let me show you an example that I use many times a week. So I have this shortcut about starting a running workout. And you can see that I go ahead and start by starting an outdoor run with an open goal in the watch. And I also turn on the water lock on the watch so my sleeves don't mess up my information. And I open the Zombies Run app, which is a really fun way to motivate yourself to run. Not going to talk about it here, but it's really cool. And then the next part is the important part for the purposes of this video. And that's that I save a file called running into shortcuts. So this text box up here allows me to give the file a name, and then I use the variable of the text field as the name of the shortcut. And then I save that to the shortcuts folder in iCloud Drive. So you might be wondering, what's the point of saving that into iCloud Drive? Great, there's a file named running, but what does that do? Enter Hazel. So my main Hazel installation is on an always-on Mac Mini, which is very cluttered and has lots of rules going on. So I'm just gonna show you a simplified version on a different computer. And here is that rule. It looks at the shortcuts folder, and the specific example that we're looking at right now is the running workout. So I have a Hazel rule named running workout, and its job is to look at the shortcuts folder, and if a file shows up called running, run this AppleScript, which is the same thing I showed you before, but instead the name of the task it's going to mark complete is called do running workout. And it's that section right there that can be anything I want it to be, whatever the task is. I just switch out the name of the task in Things. And in this case, it's do running workout. And then after it runs that AppleScript, go ahead and delete this file. This little empty text file with just a name goes away. And so you can see a couple other examples here are doing a morning journaling in day one, running my good morning routine shortcut, taking my vitamins, doing a workout on the days that I don't do my running workout. So in this way, Hazel can become an intermediary between shortcuts and my task manager. But it doesn't stop there. Consider attaching the same logic to things Hazel's already doing for you. I use this for things like downloading my pay stub from work every 2 weeks and downloading my mortgage statement every month. Anything that I'm having Hazel sort for me automatically that I have a reminder for is something that can be completed automatically in the background without me having to do that click, which isn't a huge deal as far as the cost of doing that click, but it definitely helps streamline and make it easier to keep so many tasks in Things when they can go away by themselves. It's really about the sum of all of the work that it saves, more so than any individual one part. So hopefully those examples gave you some inspiration for connecting the outside world with your task manager via AppleScript. But now you have a lot of AppleScript to write. So let me help you out with that. You might not be surprised that drafts is actually the place that I do all of the writing of these Apple scripts. And to make it phenomenally easier on myself, I created a drafts action to help out with that. So I have a Things version and an OmniFocus version. We'll start with the OmniFocus version because it's the simpler one. It asks me, what is the OmniFocus task ID? So the easiest way to get your OmniFocus task ID is by right-clicking on a task in OmniFocus and then selecting copy as link. And when you do that, you can paste that URL right in here. And then all you have to do is chop off everything up to the slash after task. If you go ahead and delete all that, you'll have just the task ID, hit yes. And then there it is. The AppleScript is written for you and you can copy and paste this wherever you need to. So if you need to copy this into Hazel and put it into the as an embedded script into something in Hazel, or if you need to put this into Apple Mail or wherever else you trigger your AppleScript from, there it is. It's written for you with just a couple of clicks. The Things version works the exact same way, except the Things version is asking for the name of the task. You can type it in or copy and paste it in. Just make sure there's not any white space that doesn't actually show up in your task manager. That will cause a problem if there's a space where there shouldn't be on either side. And it writes AppleScript again, this time, again, putting it where it belongs into the Things version of the AppleScript. And then you use that script in just the same way. Hazel, Apple Mail, what have you. So I hope this video helped you. And if it did, please consider liking, sharing, or subscribing. There will always be more content coming. You'll find timestamps in the video description down below to help you navigate the video and rewatch any of the parts that were interesting to you. You'll also find a link to a blog post on my site dedicated to this video, where you'll find the Apple scripts for both Things and OmniFocus that you can copy the text from. I'll also have links down there to the actions, the drafts actions that I demoed in the video, so that you can import those into drafts and have your own version. Again, I hope this video was helpful to you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.